Good morning, students. Let's learn today rules from geometry. Rules from geometry. Now we know that perimeter of polygon. Perimeter of polygon is sum of its length of its sides. Okay, sum of length of its sides. Okay, perimeter of polygon is sum of its lengths of its sides. Now we are going to learn perimeter of square. See here. Here I will draw the square. See here, I will draw the square here. This is square. Okay. Square. So perimeter of square. How to generate the rule for this? Rules from geometry. Now we have to generate the rule for this. Perimeter of square. Okay. So now perimeter of square. Perimeter of square. Square has how many sides? Square has four sides. See, how many sides does square have? Four sides. And all sides are equal. So see, for side, what letter we use here? S. Okay. S. Okay. Four sides square has, and squares all sides are equal. Okay. So perimeter of square. Perimeter of a square is equal to sum of length of its sides. Okay, sum of length of its sides. Okay, perimeter of square. What I have explained you, perimeter of polygon is sum of length of its sides. Okay, so this is also polygon. Okay, so perimeter of square, sum of length of its sides. Sum of the length of its sides. So how many sides are there? See, S plus S plus S plus S is equal to S plus S plus S plus S. Okay, perimeter of square is equal to sum of length of its sides. So S plus S plus S plus S. So how many times S it is given? See, how many times S here? Four times. S plus S plus S plus S. How many times S it is there? Four times. See, how many sides are there? Four sides. And which letter we have used? S. For side, S letter we have used. So four times S. Four times means four multiplied by S. So which rule we have generated here? Four multiplied by S. So 4 multiplied by S means 4S. 4 multiplied by S is equal to 4S. Now perimeter of rectangle. Now what is rectangle? It has 4 sides. Opposite sides are equal. See, this is rectangle. It has 4 sides. See, AB, BC, CD and AD. And its opposite sides are equal. See, this AB is equal to B. CD and AD is equal to BC. Opposite sides are equal and each angle is 90 degree. Okay, and each angle is 90 degree. So now let's learn perimeter of rectangle. Perimeter of rectangle is what we are going to do. We are going to do the sum of its all the sides. Okay, so perimeter of rectangle is equal to, see here I will not get the place, so here I am writing. Length of AB. See, this is length of rectangle and this is breadth of rectangle. So I have written here L. L means length of rectangle. And see, AD, this is breadth of rectangle. See, opposite sides are equal. So this is also breadth of rectangle. Opposite sides are equal. So this is also length of rectangle. See, if this is length of rectangle, this is also length of rectangle. So let's generate the rule for perimeter of rectangle. So what we'll write? Length of AB plus, see this length. Length of AB plus length of BC plus length or BA also we can write. Length of AD. Okay. So length of AD plus length of BC plus length of CD plus length of AD. Now if you will see AB is equal to CD. See here I am writing AB is equal to CD. Opposite sides are equal. So this is length. So L I have written. So AB is equal to CD is equal to L. Okay. And now what it is given? BC. Length of BC and length of AD. These are equal. BC plus BC is equal to AD. Okay. These are equal. So AD how much it is given? B. Okay, for this we consider the letter B, breadth. For breadth we consider B. So BC is equal to AD. So AD and BC are equal. Okay, now length of AB. Length of AB means L plus length of BC. BC means B. Okay, length of BC. BC is equal to B. We have written means breadth it is. Length of CD, this is length. Okay, how what it is? L. CD is equal to L. And length of AD, AD, AD is equal to B. CD is equal to B. So now what you got here? Two length and two breadth. 2 into length plus 2 into breadth. You got or not? See, L and L. So 2L we got, B and B. 2 breadth we got. Okay, so what will write here? 2 into length of AB. 2 into length of AB. 2 into length of AB. Understood? AB is equal to DC. So we have to take 2. These both the sides are equal. 2 sides. Okay, equal. So 2 into length of AB. Length of AB means L will come. Plus 2 into length of AD. Length of AD. See, why 2 into length of AD? See, these and this breadth. Okay, so 2 breadth are there. 2 breadth, so 2 into length of AD. Okay, so 2 into length of AD means 2L. 2 into L means 2 length. Okay. 2 into L means 2L plus 2 into length of AD. Length of AD is given L. Okay. Plus 2 into length of AD. Length of AD is given B. So 2B means 2 into L plus 2 into breadth means 2 length plus 2 breadth. What is the rule for perimeter of rectangle? 2 length plus 2 breadth. It's very easy. 2 length plus 2 breadth. Okay. Let's learn now independent and dependent variable. Independent and dependent variable. Now P means perimeter. Okay. P means perimeter. Of now this is the root we generate for the perimeter of rectangle. 2 into L plus 2 into breadth. Okay. Means 2L plus 2 breadth. This rule we have generated for the perimeter of rectangle. Now if you will observe. Here 2 variables are given. Here 2 variables are given. Yes. L and B. These are the 2 variables. And they are not dependent. They are independent. Means value of one variable does not depend on value of another variable. Okay. Value of one variable does not depend the value of on another variable. It has its own value. Perimeter of square P is equal to 4S. 4S means 4 into side. Here the variable are dependent. Here the variable are dependent. Why variable are dependent? Because the value that variable S takes determine value P. Okay. Let's learn rules from arithmetic. in that first property, commutative property of addition of two numbers. Commutative property of addition of two numbers. Now take any two numbers. Okay. Suppose if I will take 4 and 3. Okay. Addition of two numbers. See 4 plus 3. How much will get? 7. Now if I will change the order of this number. See, change the order of this number. Now I will take first 3 and then 4. I will take first 3 and then 4. See, just I change the order. First here 4 and then it is given 3. And then sum is 7. And here first what I took? 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. So change, even we change the order, the sum remains same. So which property receives commutative property? A plus B is equal to B plus A. Commutative property of addition of two numbers. A plus B is equal to B plus A. A plus B. A is 4, B is 3. Okay, so 4 plus 3 is equal to 7, you got. Now B what we consider? 3. Okay, 3 and A is 4. 3 plus 4 is B plus A. Even we got the sum same. Okay, so what commutative property says? Even we change the order, their sum does not change. It remains same. Okay. Now let's learn commutative property of multiplication of two numbers. Now in this property also, even we change the order of numbers, the product remains same. Okay, what this property says? We change the order of the numbers, even the product remains same in this property. Let's now see. Suppose if I will write, take any two numbers, 3 into 4. 3 multiplied by 4. 3 multiplied by 4. 3 fours are 12. Now I will change the order of this number. Okay. This I took last and this I took first. So now let's change the order. 4 into 3. 3 into 4 is equal to 12. So 4 into 3. 4 threes are 12. So even we change the order, the product remains same. Even we change the order of these numbers in multiplication. Yes. Even we change the order, the product remains same. So which one we can generate here? Suppose this is A and this is B. So A into B is equal to, now B, 4 is B, is equal to B into A, 3 is A. Okay. So B into A. Okay. Even we change the order of numbers, the product remains same. So what is commutative property of multiplication of two numbers? It works in multiplication. Yes. See, product remains same. So this is true. It works in this. Okay. So A into B is equal to B into A. This rule we can generate for this property. Okay. Learn now associative property of addition of numbers. Okay. Even add the numbers in any order. Okay. The answer we get same. It's easy. Okay. You have learned already this, all the properties, even though I'm explaining you again. Okay. See now, suppose if I will take 3 plus 4 plus 5. Okay. Now, see 3 plus 4. If I will do the sum of first these two numbers and then I will add the third number, we'll see 3 plus 4 plus 5. How much will get? 3 plus 4. See, I have written these numbers in the bracket. So, first we have to solve this bracket. 3 plus 4, 7. 7 plus 5. So, what answer we got? 7 plus 5, 12. Okay. Now, see. Make the group now. 3 plus 4 plus 5. Now, here see. First, in this example, what I have done? First two numbers I have written in the bracket. Now, I will put in the bracket two numbers. Let's see even we'll get answer same or not. Okay, so now 3, as it is we have to write, first we have to solve the bracket. Plus 4 plus 5, 9. So 3 plus 9, what we got? 12. 3 plus 9, what we got? 12. So now just check both the answers you got same or not. See, equal. Both are equal. Okay, if you will add this first, both the numbers, if you will keep first two numbers in the bracket and then you will add third number, you got answer 12 here. In the same example, 3 plus 4 plus 5, in this which numbers we took first in the bracket? Last two numbers, even though we got the answer 12. So, anyway, see, anyway you will do, you are going to get the answer same. Okay, you are going to get the answer same. So which rule we can generate here? Suppose this is A, this is B, this is C. Okay, so A plus B, these are we'll put in the bracket, plus C is equal to A plus into bracket. Now 4 means B plus 5 means C. Okay, so A plus B, see, A plus B, what, which variables are there in the bracket? A plus B, and after, means after completion of bracket here, C, and here A plus into bracket B plus C. So which rule we can generate here? This rule we can generate here. Let's learn associative property of multiplication of numbers. Three numbers can be multiplied in any order. In associative property, three numbers can be multiplied in any order. Okay. Now, see, you will see 3 into 4 into 5. 3 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 5. Okay. Any order, first take this two bracket. Okay, so 3 4s are 12, 12 into 5, 12 5s are 16. So what we got here? 16 we got. Okay, so now 3 numbers can be multiplied in any order. So here now we will do same numbers we will take, multiply in any order. Now first we will take this two numbers, means last two numbers. Okay, so 3 into 4 5s are 20, and now 23s are 60, so the answer remains same. If we multiply 3 numbers in any order, the answer remains same. Okay, now here which rule we can generate here? A into B into bracket into C. A, B and C. A into B, these numbers are in the bracket, multiplied by C. Okay. Is equal to A into bracket B multiplied by C. So for associative property of multiplication, which rule we can generate here? Which rule we can generate here? Into bracket A multiplied by B multiplied by C. Okay, now A multiplied by into bracket B multiplied by C. Let's learn now distributive property of multiplication over addition of numbers. While multiplying the numbers, we break up the bigger number. See, while multiplying the numbers, now see, 7 multiplied by 53. Okay, this is the bigger number. So we have to break up this number. Okay. So how we will break up this number? 7 multiplied by 53. 53 means 50 plus 3. So write this number in the bracket. 50 plus 3. Which number we have to break up? Bigger number. Greater number we have to break up. Okay. So 7 multiplied by into bracket 50 plus 3. Now, what is distributive property? See, 7 multiplied by 50. Okay, this all the properties you have learned in previous chapters. Okay, 7 0, 7, 5's are 35 plus 7 multiplied by 3. 7 multiplied by 3. 7, 3's are 21. Okay. So, what answer we got? 0 plus 1, 1, 5 plus 2, 7 and here 3. So, 371. So, you got 371. So, distributive property multiplication over addition. Means in this property what we have to do? We have to multiply the number. But in this, what we have to do? Break up the greater number. Okay. So, now what rule we can generate for this? Which rule we can generate for this? See here. Now this is suppose A, this is B and this is C. Okay. So what we'll write here now? Write the rule for this. Now which rule we can generate here? See, this is A, this is B, this is C. Okay. So write here A multiplied by bracket, right, as it is. C here B plus C. So A into bracket B plus C. So A multiplied by B is equal to, now see here, is equal to A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by C. A multiplied by C. Okay, so which rule we can generate here? A into bracket B plus C is equal to A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by C. Okay, this is for your understanding I have written. Okay.